Hi, everybody. This is Jennifer with ChoiceSlides.com. And in this tutorial, I'm going to go over the updated Clapboard slide style. The original Clapboard was made in ProShow Producer 4, which didn't have text layers. Now that we're on ProShow 7, I thought it'd be about time to update this slide style. So if you have the original, you remember you had to add some captions, save it as a still file, bring it back in, and then they would fade in one after the other, and it was a pretty big process before we had text layers. Now you have text layers. So this slide style is going to be a lot easier than it used to be to use. It's almost going to be as simple as simply typing in your new text. Almost. I'll show you what you might have to do in order to make this work, depending on what you're writing in and whether you change your font or not. So this slide style does have one image, and that's your background. So to start, you can just drag one photo into a slide. This is a relatively long slide style because it, you know, you want to have time for all of the text to come up and then everyone to be able to read it. So make sure your slide time is at least 18 seconds. And I also have 2 seconds in and 2 seconds out for the transitions. These don't have to be exact. You can make them a little bit shorter, a little bit longer. I wouldn't go a whole lot shorter just because your audience wants to have time to read everything. You can go a little bit longer, but the keyframes are going to adjust appropriately. So long as you have around 18 to 22 seconds for your slide time, you're going to be just fine. So if you've imported the slide style, and you would have done that simply by double-clicking on the slide style icon, you'll find it under the Choice Slides category. And if you have the original, I did save this as a different name. So your original, you would have the clapboard blank, the clapboard style. If for whatever reason you still want to use that one, this will not overwrite it. The new one is called Clapboard with Text Layers. And you'll notice this says it has zero captions. Well, that's true. I actually did not use any captions. It does have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 text layers. So this is a little misleading. It does have caption layers, but they're text layers down here in the layer list, not captions. So you would simply hit Apply Style, OK. And there's everything, your photos at the back. And all of your text just comes right in. And they default to say your production title, this scene, this date. Obviously, you can change those to be whatever you want. The default font that I used is Trebuchet. Most PCs will already have this. So if you already have this, then you would just retype what you want, and everything will work perfectly so long as you're just kind of retyping. Let me show you what you might need to change if you are keeping this font. All of the text layers are set to a left alignment. So no matter how much you're writing, the you're going to start where it should, which is part of the design. So in this case, let's say I'm going to say Amy and Brent's wedding. Okay, oops, gotta spell it right though, huh? Okay, as you noticed, I am off the board, okay? And this may happen. I don't know what you're going to write, so obviously this might happen to you. You might have a really long title. The nice thing about these being left aligned, you really should only have to change your font size. Let's bring it down, and it just, everything's gonna scoot over. Okay, so that's nice. The problem is that they haven't quite fixed this yet. This little issue's been around for a little while. That change isn't going to be global. So if I jump over to my text effects, you'll see in this first keyframe, the font size is 24. Well, if I jump over to keyframe 2, it jumps back up to 30. I really wish that they would fix this. They know about it, but they have their reasons for not changing this. When you make a change here in the text settings, when keyframes already exist, and of course they do because I've designed this, it's already pre-designed, the keyframe's already there, that change is not global. So instead of clicking on each one of these keyframes and changing it, what you'll want to do is on that first keyframe where I changed my font size, right click on it. I know you got a ton of choices and sometimes it's hard to find the right one. You want to choose copy size to all keyframes on this text layer. Okay, so this is going to copy the size to all of the keyframes only on this text layer, and that's what you want. So I'm going to click that. now my second keyframe is 24, my third keyframe is 24. So now as it goes through, it'll stay the same. The you'll see that it shrinks back. That's because it's a text layer, and I didn't shrink it back here. I shrunk it in size here. So you shouldn't have to mess with these at all. Just the text settings, okay? And that's basically the kinds of things that you're going to have to deal with, either because what you wanted to write was longer and it didn't fit, or if you wanted, say, you want a really nice scripty font. Let's say I happen to like tangerine a lot. I'm going to say tangerine, okay? So I changed this scene to, let's say, we're going to call this the dress, okay? That font is really nice, but it's a little bit small. When you change the font, the words may get bigger or smaller, even though the size stays the same. Each font is a little bit different. So that's, I changed the font, therefore I might want to change the size. So again, I would actually bump this one up to say 36. Plus I've only got two words. If this was a longer title, I might not need to. Okay, but again, same thing's happening. I changed the size, but it only changed it on the first keyframe. So keyframe one, 36. Keyframe two drops back down to 30. So keyframe one, I'm going to right-click on my font size and choose copy size to all keyframes on this text layer. Okay, you'll notice this is 36, but my first one, we actually went down to 24. So that's why I don't change it. You know, you have an option to copy size to all text layers on the slide. Well, but you may not want that size for every single text layer. Okay, so now we've got Amy and Brent's wedding, the dress, the date may be, again, you may have a lot of words. Let's say they're getting married in September. Oh, I'm on the wrong one. And that's going to happen to you too. So I'm not even going to edit that out. This date, make sure you're on the right layer. This date, September, say 23rd, 2015. Again, just way off the charts. I'm like, I can't even see it. So this might need to come way down. Okay. And let's change the font to tangerine. So now I've got a really long word and I've changed my font so it's even crazy small. So then you just simply play with your font size. That actually looks pretty good, 30. Which actually, that stayed the same because the original one was 30. We brought the dress up because it was small. Okay, that really should be it. Okay, so depending on how many words you have, the font you choose, that's going to determine your font size, okay? And then the more information, that you know, those are two other text layers. You may not even want those. You may only have one line. You may have two. But it all is the same thing. Because these are all set to left alignment, you shouldn't have any issues with moving the text around. If you do, you're going to run into some problems, so I don't recommend it. There's a bunch of keyframes you probably don't want to mess with. So just change your font and the size. Now the font of course is global, the size is not. So when you change your font size, just make sure that you come over here to your text effects layer and change it, the size to all keyframes on that text layer. And once you have done that, you're done, okay? So you're probably going to have just a couple of things to change with the font size, but this update is going to be so much easier to use than the previous one. That's what this is all about, making them just a little bit easier to use. Okay, so thanks so much for watching, and I hope this slide style gives your show that really professional-looking title slide. Mm-hmm.